Why shouldn't someone get a septic charger?
Talking to engineers or marketing people.
Okay, now this is not approved by the PR team, but I do believe that. All right, everybody. Good afternoon from Power to Drive 2025. I'm here with
Tanya Garvik, the Global Sales Director in Zaptec. And you are?
My name is Danik Vasha. I am the Managing Director for Germany. And we're here to talk a little bit with you about the event, but also EVs and common myths and everything. So we're hosting a little live podcast in our meeting room. I hope you can hear us well. So let's get started with some fun questions that some customers brought up to us as well today. Tanya, I'll ask you the first question. What's a common myth people have about EV charging, in your opinion?
So one thing that's very easy to think about when it comes to charging is the range anxiety people have.
Oh, yes.
That's one thing. So that's the first thing that comes to mind. But what I feel is more actually a myth is people don't really understand the complexity and the smartness of the charger. Because, I mean, a charger can do so much. You can charge when electricity is cheapest. You can communicate with the house through the smart functions in the house. And people just think it's like an iPhone charger. Well, we have a really cool smart charger.
I agree. There's a lot more potential to it, isn't it?
100%. Okay, Danielle, then I want to follow up. What is the weirdest place you've seen a septic charger?
We actually had an installer in Germany who installed a septic go inside an old tree. So I think they put the cables inside tree closure, let's call it that. And it's at the edge of a forest. I forgot the town it's in, but as far as I know, it's still active. So it might be the most outdoorsy septic go install. I'm a bit proud that it's installed in
Germany. Getting kind of like a cozy village vibe in that one, don't you?
It is. It's very fun. It's like the little charger you see when your range anxiety hits and you need a few more kilometers to charge. So it meets you there.
Okay. We will go look.
All right. Tony, the next one I want to ask you is an interesting one because every one of you who came to our booth actually brought this up, especially since we launched Go2. And I think ever since EV adoption has been kind of progressing across Europe, especially in the Nordics, the energy transition and the potential of vehicle to grid is on everyone's mind.
Mm.
And as much as we can talk about grid codes and regulations, and the second one might be the big one for us, explain in your words, vehicle to grid to a 10-year-old. Very simple. How would you describe it to a kid when they ask, what is this big fuzz about?
Okay, so like baseline, electricity is something that is produced right now. And if you don't use it right now, it disappears. So that's one of the things. So sometimes you produce too much and something disappears, or you produce too little. So with the vehicle to grid capability, we actually want to use the car as say a battery storage for the grid, so that if your house needs electricity, you can provide your house with electricity to support the grid, or you can bring from your car electricity down to the grid to support the grid, because if you don't need the electricity right now, someone else might. So that is kind of the idea of vehicle to grid, that you support the grid.
I think that's really what it is, right? It's pushing energy from A to B and when you most need it. And we have this in this discussion, you mentioned range anxiety. We have this in Germany where majority of people are very nervous. Am I going to be able to get from A to B? And if I do so, what if I have a longer work trip? Will I be able to charge somewhere on the road? But we know that, you know, the majority of people, at least in this country, commutes 22 kilometers a day. The battery lasts way more than that. So you're basically pushing. And again, the mindset is, oh, I have 80% battery left. Let me charge it back up to 100. And so you're basically driving, as you said, energy around that you don't use right now. And I'm really curious how the topic will progress on one hand, but also how someone who's 9 years old today, 10 years from now, when they drive an EV and they have their driver's license and drive, that most likely will become a totally normal thing for them, right?
Yeah, and that's the thing about vehicle to grid. You want it to be the most normal thing, and that is just going to be an automatic.
Yeah.
You don't understand how this wasn't the standard before. Okay, so Daniel, when it comes to the septic chargers, we love everything about them, basically.
We're a little biased, but yeah.
Yeah, we're a little biased, but we appreciate being biased. We stand up for being biased here.
Yeah. We do.
Okay. So since you know the chargers quite well, what is one of the features that you think people don't appreciate enough?
I think when we look at products and markets, and especially we spoke about V2G and innovation and all those things, I do believe that there's more interest usually in cutting edge features and what's next and what's tomorrow. Mm. But the safety aspect of things is something really close to heart for us, especially the more chargers we install and the more this becomes not just a commodity, but something people use to transfer energy back around. I think safety is something that needs to be highlighted way more. And 100%. We have sensors in a Zaptec Go, for example, we have sensors that can measure humidity and temperature. So if we see variations in that, our system and our support team is able to actually detect those things. The system is able to shut down charging speed. And it sounds very, very simple. And it sounds like something people expect when they buy an EV charger, but it's definitely not something everyone does. Yeah. And not a lot of customers requested those things, but we built them in because that's how we do things. Mm. And that is most definitely one thing I appreciate. It's the things we do that you might not always notice, including the water scale in the Zaptec Go when you install it, the lever, yeah, so you know if you're level. Installing it evenly. Mm. It's those little things for us.
Even definitely. That you can just like use one tool to install a Zaptec Go is something that is very easy to not think about.
We get that a lot, especially the, as you said, one tool, but also the speed of how you're able to click the cables and connect them actually, and just setting them up through the app. Once you try it, you usually don't want to go back. I'll make that claim right now.
No, but what it's so easy to forget why chargers or charging stations were built. And that is the safety aspect of it. If it's not fully the agree. Safest charger, you don't want it. I want my charger to be able to charge at night. Yeah. Well, I feel I bought the best and safest product so that when it's charging at night, I feel safe with my family in the house.
Yeah.
And that's like the key function, the safety. And I know my family is as safe as possible while charging at night.
Why shouldn't someone get a Zaptec charger?
Well, I would say one of the reasons. So if I am to find a reason to not buy a Zaptec charger, it must be if you only want a stupid charger that charges when you want your, like charges immediately.
Yeah.
Because of course with Zaptec, we have the eco mode and we have a lot of functions that make it smart. But if you want a stupid charger, that's one of the reasons.
Yeah. It's kind of like an ecosystem, right? You want to connect to CPOs or you want to connect to energy providers, and we do collaborate a lot with them. And sometimes people just have a second house and, you know, they might are looking for a low cost option, and that's okay. There's many companies in this sector. I think our credo or focus has always been, we want to offer a product that works for most people. And I do want to highlight most people because you can never make everyone happy.
Mm.
And I've learned that over the past few years. But more so, again, you know, if you want to keep adding features and have a system that goes with the times, you're definitely on the safe side. And again, safe side, I think the safety and quality aspect of it is definitely something that people should look forward to when they buy a Zaptec charger.
But also, I do want to say with the Zaptec Go-To,
yes.
Making everyone happy is a little bit of what we've tried to do, because we feel like we have everything built into one charger. But of course, again, if you want a stupid charger charging when you plug it in, that's one thing. But if you really want a charger that has everything, trying to make everyone happy, premium, that's your Zaptec Go-To.
This is what someone asked us today. They said, why didn't we just buy a third-party MID meter and put it in? What's the benefit of having the charger certified as a measuring device itself? And it's really none. They just love to do that in the tech team.
Yeah.
Lost a few arguments over that one. But I believe what you said is right. We try to please more people with one product. We have a lean portfolio, right? But especially when it comes to the safety aspect, temperature regulations and all that, I do think we add it to what we already had, right?
Yeah, I agree. Okay, Daniel, I have some questions. This or that.
Oh, here we
go. So you have to choose between two options in each question.
Sure.
Okay. Talking to engineers or marketing people?
I'm a big fan of marketing, but I would say equal. But these days, engineers.
Yeah.
I think there's always something new to learn.
I think, but also with engineers, the spark in their eyes when they see the advantage that Zaptec brings to the table. I love every time we have a tech meeting and you can see their eyes light up because of the patented phase balancing solution, or that we have a free portal, or
there's a lot we do there to be proud of, right?
Yeah, for
but
sure.
I would pick love the marketing team, but engineers, you win this one.
Yeah, I had a really nice one today with the RCD Type B built in with the CPO that was amazed that you don't have to go out and reset it yourself, because every time it kind of fails, it resets itself. So it's so time saving for the CPOs. So I love that, like, glimpse in their eyes.
You know, here it's funny, you have a few installed chargers here in Germany or in other countries where it might be a big building, but not everyone drives an EV yet. Can you imagine in Norway or Sweden going into one of those 400, 500 charger projects and manually up the RCD each time?
Yeah, there's actually, in a town in Sweden, there's a guy resetting it at once a week, driving around town to reset it, because it's a time consuming job. No, it's a thing though. Okay, Daniel, to round things off a little bit, what is your thought about where we're going in the future and what the most important aspect will be?
Okay, now this is not approved by the PR team, but I do believe that when you go to these events that we're right at, there's a lot of conversation on vehicle to grid and you know, the most advanced technology ever. But there's, in my opinion, a lot of very mediocre stuff, you know, and we try to improve and we always try to do better. We're not perfect as a company. But I think we don't really talk about what happens if you need to speak to someone and what happens if the hardware doesn't work and you need to charge and get from A to B. And I do think a lot of people don't really give a crap about it. It's just about selling products, but not actually caring about people who use it, being available when there's something. And, you know, it's always fun showing a product, but can you scale it? Can you produce it in a safe way in the hundreds of thousands? Do you have a support team that works? And that will become essential. And I just think there's a lot of things that look nice, but a bit dirty when you look closer.
Yeah, 100%.
I do have a question for you to end this up with. And I think when you're at these events, you've been how long now at Zaptec?
4 years.
4 years. I think this industry is, and I want to bring that angle in because I think it's very interesting. When we look at energy companies and CPOs, and each country is very different. And many young companies, of course, come in at a very open angle. It's young teams, energetic teams. But of course, you know, ultimately the base installers, for example, it's a very male-dominated industry, a bit more old school, especially in countries like Germany. How is that for you starting in for a product like this, you know, where you speak a lot with installers? How did you feel like it was to go into this industry as a woman and basically get these products down to customers?
Okay, so first of all, I started my career in the maritime industry, which is male-dominated.
You mentioned this, yeah.
So I would say, like, going to this industry, which is also male-dominated, it's way more women in this industry. So this industry has gone or come much longer than the maritime industry. But what you notice as a woman every time is if someone is walking up to me and someone in my team, they don't really start talking to me before they see my business card that I'm the highest rank. But it's something just like an inner bias when it comes to females and tech, that they don't think that women know their stuff. So every time I'm in a meeting and I say, take it alone or do the tech presentation alone, they're like, oh, so you know this stuff. So it's cool when you can contradict their beliefs, but you can clearly notice that there are beliefs about women and tech and their technical capabilities.
I guess that's across the board, not just EV charging, right? It's
yes.
A tech thing.
Yes. It's an assumption, an underlying assumption that you're not necessarily aware about yourself, but it's just built into you.
Could you install a septic charger on the wall?
I can. And I would if
there
I was
go,
allowed
guys.
To.
Gentlemen, just so you know.
I'm not allowed to.
Tanya Charge coming near you.
Give me a couple of years and I'll become an electrician.
Well, it looks like it's getting busy out there. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.